Hello everyone and welcome back to Wondershare Repairit, a professional tool that can help you solve corrupted videos or images just for you. I'm Josiah from Wondershare Repairit, and today we're going to be talking about the differences between MPEG2, MPEG4, and H.264. Many people can get confused when it comes to encoding, and that's why you have to have a significant video format comparison. But what is a significant difference between MPEG2, MPEG4, and H.264? And we have the answers to all those questions. But before, I wanna ask you guys to leave a comment down below if you have any questions on video codec and formats. And also, since you're down there, make sure you go and subscribe to the channel. Data compression and decompression standards include MPEG2, MPEG4, and H.264. But what distinguishes one video coding format from the others? Continue watching this video to find out. And also stay tuned to know some amazing facts about all the formats. Now, coming to the first part, what is MPEG2? What is MPEG4 and H.264? We have to understand them individually. Moving to the first video coding format, MPEG2, a standard created to encode high quality videos, and it's mainly used for DVD media. In 1995, MPEG2, a standard for the general encoding of moving pictures and related audio information, was released. For broadcast quality television, there are transportation video and audio requirements. So what is MPEG2? Well, it had a far broader scope and appeal, as it supported interlacing and high definition. Because it has been chosen for the compression technique for the over-the-air digital TV, ATSC, DVB, and ISDB, digital satellite TV services like Dish Network, digital cable television transmissions, SVCD, and DVD, MPEG2 is considered crucial. It's also used in Blu-ray discs. However, for high definition content, it's usually MPEG4, Part 10, or SMPTE-VC1. Well, now coming to the features, MPEG2 is actually quite more superior compared to the other formats. The significant advantage of using it is that it has a higher quality compared to the other formats. Also, the method is quite simple for video compression. The last unique feature that MPEG2 has, it has the ability to handle video streams from DVDs, cable operators, and other local sources. The distinction between MPEG2 and MP4 is that MP4 can store subtitles, still photos, and other types of data in addition to videos, whereas MPEG2 is only capable of storing video. When it comes to MP4, it is used to make high definition videos that you can view on your computer, on your cell phone, or on other devices. DVDs and basic digital television broadcasts, as well as video compact discs for lower quality videos, are MPEG2 exclusives. Also, MP4 are compressed with MPEG4 compression methods, containing several parts and including MPEG4. Did you know that MPEG2 was primarily developed by Sony, Thomson, and Mitsubishi Electric? You heard that right. After it was released, the video format became a standard for SD digital television and DVDs. However, MPEG2 versus MPEG4 is something you need to know about because they are not the same. And to know the difference between the two, stay tuned. Now, moving on to another standard video format, which was created in 1995. It was approved as a committee draft in March of 1998, and it was completed at the end of the same year. It was initially designed to accommodate extremely low bit rates, but it can now support up to 4 Mbps. Visual Software Systems Delivery Multimedia Integration Framework, DMIF, conference testing and audio are the 6 components that enable MPEG4 to accomplish its duties. The video encoding standard was created for broadcasts, conversational, and interactive programs. It's also built to handle scalability based on content. Now, coming to the features of MPEG4, here are the following. It's an integration of both natural and synthetic content in the object form. Now, you may ask what an object form is. It's actually a representation of recorded entities, such as a chair or a person, or synthetic material, such as a face, a person, or an animated 3D model. And along with that, MPEG4 supports both 2D and 3D content. Also, all types of interactivity are supported. It can code at extremely low rates. That means 5 kilobits per second for video, and 2 kilobits per second for audio, and move all the way up to very high rates, like 64 kilobits per second for CD audio quality. MPEG4 being a mixture of lots of video formats can extend VRML's native support for natural and real-time streaming content by using URLs. A broad range of its bit rates, quality and services, as well as applications and resolutions, can also work in MPEG4 codec. Did you know that MPEG4 has adopted all the fantastic features from MPEG1 and MPEG2 and also VRML? These mixed features mean that MPEG4 can be used for both online or television context. And content from both channels can be integrated into the same multimedia environment. Now, finishing up with MPEG, I have a question for you. Have you ever heard of the H.264 codec? Now, moving on to the next video format, here is the most used video format worldwide. And so what is H.264? The International Telecommunications Union as H.264 and the International Organization for Standardization, International Electrotechnical Commission Moving Picture Experts Group collaborated to develop H.264, a video compression technique or codec. As a result, the names H.264 and AVC have identical meanings and can be used interchangeably. H.264 is a video codec that can be used in a variety of container formats, including the MPEG4 container format, which uses the .mp4 extension, QuickTime.mov, Flash.f4v, 3GP for mobile phones, and the MPEG transport stream. Well, the H.264 codec has several features, so let's go over them. A codec based on the H.264 standards compresses a digital video file or stream to use half of the amount of the storage space or the network bandwidth as a MPEG2. The codec can keep the same video quality whilst using half of its storage because of its compression. The goal of H.264 or AVC formats was to create a new digital video standard capable of delivering high quality video at the significantly lower bit rate compared to prior formats. This is without complicating the design. To keep implementation feasible, and relatively inexpensive. Did you know that the most used H.264 codec includes the Apple codec used in Apple Compressor and QuickTime Pro? Then there are the main concept formats and the X.264 codec, which are widely and daily used H.264 codecs. That said, there are several differences between MPEG4, MPEG2, and H.264. 1. Difference in file quality. Amongst all three video formats, MPEG2 is the one that provides the best. Then comes MPEG4, and the least in line is H.264 format. Number 2, differences in file size. MPEG2 has a greater file size than MPEG4 and H.264, making it harder to use on portable devices and broadcast video over the internet. MPEG4, on the other hand, can work across mobile networks without sacrificing quality due to its high rate of compression in smaller file sizes. 3. Difference in using frequency. MPEG4 codec adds more interactive features to your videos, allowing you to change the different components in real time. H.264 offers the most versatility, allowing it to be used in various applications on a variety of systems and networks. 4. Difference in file structure. MPEG2 is the best way to employ it if you wish to encode digital data on DVDs. MPEG4 codec is the encoding standard of choice for encoding digital material online and on portable devices. The H.264 standard is recommended as the most often utilized format for video encoding on Blu-ray discs. 5. Difference in file suitability. In comparison to the MPEG4, the MPEG2 video compression formats is much easier to utilize. H.264 format, on the other hand, is an open standard with a published specification that almost anyone may implement. Since 1967, digital video coding has gone a long way. As the first digital coding standard, H.120 was chosen. That said, over the years, video codecs and formats have changed. Well, do not forget to install Wondershare Repairit to fix many various video formats. And thank you for taking your time to watch this video. Please let us know if you have any concerns or just any thoughts about the differences of formats or just anything in general, and we'll try to help you answer that. And also, since you're down there, make sure you like this video and subscribe to have educational content.